Hey, what's up, everybody? David Contreras, the Actor Selling Homes. Want to show you downtown Salt Lake City in the springtime, even with loud motorcycles. But anyway, happy spring. It's beautiful. Yes, I have a long coat and like four layers of clothes, which is kind of useless. But again, I wanted to look good. Anyway, I'm going to be showing you a special treat of this listing for, I believe it's 2.995. I'll double check, but it's an exclusive condo, three bedroom, three bathroom, a little under 3,000 square feet. Sorry about that, 3,000 square feet. If you pan over there, we have two towers, the American Plaza Towers, very exclusive downtown Salt Lake City off of Main Street. It's a 1982 build, however, fully renovated. So we're gonna go ahead and walk over there really quick, get access, because there's a bellman and it's very posh. And then we'll continue with the thing. The actual address is 48 West, 300 South. Like I said, American Plaza Towers, which is the North Tower and the South Tower. This particular listing, as I said a few seconds ago, is on the 25th floor. But anyway, we're gonna go up. We're just looking for the main entrance. And once we get in there, we're gonna go up to the 25th floor. There's a, from what I noticed on the pictures, there's an indoor pool, indoor racquetball courts, multiple. The amenities are amazing. Then again, the HOA is $1,100 a month. So yeah, and even the top, even though the 25th floor doesn't have, they do have access, but it's not part of the amenity. There is a helipad on the top of the building, apparently for the penthouse. So let's go ahead and get in and we'll go from there. So we just went up to the second floor from the main office. Now we're gonna be going to, this is exciting content, so we're gonna be going across the sky bridge or a bridge hallway, a long hallway in other words, going from the south tower to the north tower. And we should be coming across the, or past the pool. And what was it, the other thing I said? The racquetball court, so the pool. Indoor pool, which is pretty cool, hot tub. Not being used, which is a shame. Now, I will say not that great of a view if you're looking at the pool because you should see brick, but it. And then there should be some racquetball courts right over here. Down there. Oh yeah. So look at that racquetball. Oh, it's open, I thought it was a window. Racquetball courts. One and two. As thrilling as this walk will be, I think we're just gonna cut and then just go on. Part of the amenities, in addition to the pool and the racquetball courts, apparently there's a room for billiards. If you're into playing pool, then you have access to this room. You have, what is that, three pool tables? All right. What else do we have? Conference room right there. Well, the library's good. Yeah, and bathrooms. Alright, so 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, and 25. So there's only two more levels. I guess 26, and then there's the roof. So floor 25. And we're going to unit 2502. Right there.
Oh.
Now pan away, because I'm going to put the code. I will remind you that this is a 1982 build. So yes, it is somewhat old. However, as you can see from the entrance, it's fully remodeled. Here to my left, you have room for plenty of coats when you entertain and make your all-white parties. As I said, the roof has, it's a common area. It has a hot tub. Does not have a pool, but it's got gorgeous 360 degree views of downtown Salt Lake City. You can see the Wells Fargo building off of Main Street. You can see everything all the way down to, I'm assuming, like Harriman, southwest end of the valley. If you look the, you know, towards the west, you can see the Great Salt Lake, basically everything, and including the mountains. So here by this closet, we have the first bathroom. That's cool. Look at that mirror with the light. It's backlit. And it's got pendant lighting fixtures. Obviously, you know, nothing too special, but I think that
that makes it really, really cool. So custom sink, obviously countertops, and I really like the mirror. Okay, so we got 8-foot ceilings all the way across. It is an older build, so that's why you get the 8-foot, you know, height. Here we have one of the 3 bedrooms. Looks like this one is the primary residence, primary suite. I love the wood flooring, by the way, all the way, this whole level, wood flooring. Behind this door, we have pretty spacious closet. And I love the idea of keeping the wood flooring all throughout. There's no carpeting. So closet, and then plenty of room for even a bigger TV if you want. Behind door number 2, we have the ensuite bathroom, walk-in shower on rollers, which is pretty cool. Now it's simple, again, it's very simple, but I think sometimes simple is more. Go ahead and close this door because that's how they left it. And behind door number 3, we have yet another closet. So I guess you could say that's a his and hers. Okay, so pretty spacious. And it's got, from what I noticed, it's got speakers. So you have speakers in your primary suite. Okay, so 1 of 3 bedrooms. We have storage space built into the actual wall. I guess just for your media, as you can see right here. Your media and cables and whatnot. I love the flow. Obviously, it's when we talk about open concept, this is definitely, it checks that off. So if, let's turn on those lights actually. Okay, so you have the main entrance right to my left. Your right, we have the dining, the official dining space with the really cool chandelier, as you can see right here with the polished steel. Now we have an oversized, you can see this is definitely not original to the 1982 build. So you can see the remodel, the work, it was extensive. Love the waterfall effect. Perfect sitting for 4. I love, again, I'm a huge fan of lighting, custom lighting fixtures, and this one, they will kind of look like dice. Pendant lighting right over the sink. We have, again, the color palette is, you know, they went with, the wall kind of comes off as blue or like a some sort of gray, but it contrasts really well with the countertop with the wood flooring and then the dark palette on the actual cabinets. I always make a note to point out that the cabinets go all the way up to the ceiling. There's no awkward gap on top. Look at the backsplash. I don't know if that comes across, but it's got like this like scaly texture and it's chrome. I think that's very, very cool. In addition, having the stainless steel appliances. This right here, oh, rooms for your Stanleys. Pretty cool. Very nice. And then obviously adjoining to that, we have the other one with your glassware. Very cool. Yeah, they definitely put in a lot of work in this condo. Like I said, it's on the market for about $2.2 million, but they definitely put in a lot more. You can see the fridge right there, large fridge. Across from the kitchen, you have the side-by-side wash and dryer. They are elevated, so you have plenty of cabinet space, room to hang out your clothes, and behind this, oh yeah, look, there's actual, if you wanna come in, more storage and an actual sink. I'm really liking the kitchen, that the countertop, very, very nice. Behind the kitchen, we have, okay, so this, let's see what this is. It's like a mudroom. Okay, so this is another access point to the hallway, yeah. There's two ways. There's a main entrance and there's this, I'm assuming, for groceries. And I'm guessing this is just more of the, I guess, pantry. Yeah. So hidden away, I think it's kind of cool. Just hidden away a pantry where you can go ahead and store all of your toasters and all of the espresso machines. And then more built-in storage. So, off camera, I just learned that there's a technical name for this in its garage, what was it?
Appliance garage.
Appliance garage. So I did not know that. I just learned something new. So appliance garage, which obviously, you know, very flush with the wall, and it just looks really well, aesthetically really cool. I just opened that door. So you have the appliance garage right here, but then the technical or official pantry is right here. So you have plenty of space to put in your food. You have that, the appliance garage right here, and then back there. So you're not gonna run out of any space to put in your appliances for the kitchen or the food. So like I said, laundry room, beautiful kitchen, especially this is my standout right now. You have the family room with a gorgeous view of the west and southwest end of the Salt Valley. Enough room to put in a very large couch, as you can see here. You're a cinema, you're a musician, you can have your own grand piano. So you have your official family room, but then behind you, I guess you could say it's the formal, living room. So you can say this is the living room and then that's the family room. Again, in other words, a large and large space. So if you look out the window, we're on the 25th floor, there's two more. The 26 and then the rooftop, where that's where the penthouse is, which in fact I just learned that the seller of this condo is also the owner of the penthouse, but we're actually jumping from 2 million to 6 million at that point. Okay, so obviously custom lighting, as you can see, just pan to the ceiling, lots of light coming in, not only through the windows. Right now it's about 3, almost 4 o'clock. Plenty of afternoon sun. It's a beautiful, gorgeous day outside, as you saw from the outside. We have the office, which I'm assuming this is one of the three bedrooms. They are using it as an office. So it could be a bedroom. I'm guessing this right here is a closet. Yep, so you got it. Well, actually, yeah, you got a safe and you got more of an office, yeah. I guess you could use it as a bedroom, but I would use it as an office. Pretty cool office, pretty cool view. If you pan that way through that window, you can see, come this way right here, you can see City Hall, downtown Salt Lake. This is just off of State Street and between 5th and 6th South. Actually 4th and 5th South. And a gorgeous view of the mountains, by the way. Looks like a postcard out this window. Okay, so bedroom number two. Bedroom number one was over there. Room for your grand piano. You got the formal living room, family room, gorgeous kitchen. And again, I will note again, beautiful wood flooring. And then behind this we have, okay, now it makes me wonder, maybe that one bedroom we saw towards the entrance was not the master suite, because this one's even bigger. Okay, so it looks, by the looks of it, there are two primary suites. This one is slightly bigger than the one by the entrance. So that is a really big guest bedroom, in my opinion. This is the guest, the primary suite. So right now we got the covers on the windows right now, the shades. But again, you're gonna get a gorgeous view of the Salt Lake Valley. And then right behind this hallway, this is where we have the master, not master. I gotta get away from using the word master. That's something I definitely gotta work on. The primary bathroom. Love the mirrors, love the lighting, pendant lighting. All right. And then as you pan around, you have even more space. So you have a little vanity right here, but then you have the his and hers. As you can see, sinks right over there. Beautiful mirrors, the lighting fixtures. You have a jetted tub. And look at the backsplash. Look at that, it's like marble. I'm not sure if that's marble, but it's definitely a cool backsplash in the jetted tub. And then also the stand-in Euro shower. And then as glamorous as it can be, you have your toilet room in there. Pretty cool bathroom in my opinion. Wood flooring with like the marble tile floor. So again, this, oh, I even missed another spot, look at this. So this is the primary closet. And this is a very large primary closet. So very cool. So yeah, so I was complaining to Ron about that first bedroom. Look, for a lot of properties, that would be the primary suite. But this is the official primary suite. So those are the three bedrooms, this one being the main one. So I think we looked at the whole property. As I said, I will go ahead and to wrap up. Three bedrooms, three bathrooms. We have a 1982 build, fully remodeled in the American West Plaza
buildings, towers here in downtown Salt Lake City. Gorgeous views. Like just by standing here, if you just look that way, you can see the mountain, you can see City Hall. So proximity to basically anything, whether it's the Eccles Theater, if you want to catch a Broadway show, Abravanel Hall, if you want to go to Temple Square during the Christmas lights, if you want to go and go on Keys on Main off of Main Street right by the Wells Fargo building, so live music. You want to go catch a jazz game, just get on the track station that's literally just a block east and you just ride for free all the way down to the Delta Center, Abravanel Hall, Gateway Mall, City Creek is just a 3-minute walk going north. You're centrally to everything that you could want when it comes to entertainment, dining, basically everything. Farmer's Market, actually this way, I think down 300 South, you have Pioneer Park. Awesome Farmer's Market, by the way. So, if you're looking for a property where there's a primary residence, an investment property in a very hot market, look no further. $2.2 million, a little under 3,000 square feet. I don't know if we can get access to the actual roof, so I'm gonna end the video now, but if I get access to the roof, I'd like to show you. So other than that, we just got security to give us the clearance to the highly undisclosed area, which is the rooftop of this building. As you can see, literally 360 degrees of, and it's just such a perfect day to be making this video. As you can see, they have lighting for night entertainment, several places to be sitting. You got a barbecue, and again, it's a common area, so all the residents, including the one unit that we just showed you, has access to this. So we have a barbecue right here, a barbecue right there, and then right behind the grills, you have the hot tub. But check out these views. My goodness. So you have Salt Lake International Airport right there, Antelope Island, a few minutes heading north. The brand new, if you look right there, you have the newish Hyatt Regency Hotel. You have Temple Square right over there, 99 West Plaza, which is that high rise right over there. You have the Capitol Building, which we were at earlier today, which again, my wife is a professional photographer, and that is one of the most beautiful places in all of Salt Lake Valley to do family portraits, engagements. You know, if you need a new headshot, you can do that. So let me know if you need to get a hold of Ellie for that. But again, look at this view. You got the University of Utah right over there, Primary Children's Hospital. As I showed you just a few moments ago, you have a 2-minute walk, if that, to go to the City Hall. You have Salt Palace right there. Basically anything you could want. Like, we were just having lunch down there. You can't really see it because the Hotel Monaco is blocking it, but if you're into German food, you have Siegfried's literally right there. That's one block. So beautiful view. Here's the hot tub that we were just talking about. There you go. And again, just a lot more sitting space to invite your guests. Imagine at night how it looks like this city, you know, landscape, the cityscape must look amazing. Now again, I haven't been on it here at night. Ellie, on the other hand, has. You have Interstate I-15 heading up north to Farmington and obviously Davis County. You head south that way. About 20-25 minutes takes you to the south end west or southwest end of the valley, like Daybreak, South Jordan, Harriman. You go southeast, that corner right over there, we have Draper, and then you go into past that mountain right over there, you go into the Silicon Slopes and Lehigh, Utah County. So anyway, very, very cool listing. So if it is within your price budget, in this case $2.2 million, do let me know. I'm glad that this is the last minute walkthrough. We were just, again, eating literally lunch just a few minutes ago, and I pulled up the MLS, saw this listing. Ellie said that she'd been in this building. Perfect. So if you have any questions regarding the listing, anything related to downtown Salt Lake City, I will point out, I was just looking, that park right there is Pioneer Park. So you have about 2.5 blocks to one of the coolest farmers market in Salt Lake City. And then off to the right, over there behind those buildings, you have the Delta Center. So jazz games, Now, if you're a soccer player like me and you want to go over to the Real Salt Lake Stadium, America First Field, you will have to jump on I-15 and then head about 15, 20 minutes. But anyway, I'm just rambling on at this point. Let me know if you have any questions regarding the Utah real estate market, Salt Lake City, this listing. All right, peace.